Top 5 ghost videos so scary I disappeared for a week. Alright, let's go!
Ghosts, caught on camera.
Let's go!
Hiding under the covers.
Okay.
Over on the YouTube channel, Austin's Vinyl Corner, this guy, whose name is Austin, uploads videos where he discusses and reviews vinyl records and talks about all things related to music collecting. Natural. In the video, Austin explains that he was sent some spooky CCTV footage by one of his co-workers who claims that her house is extremely haunted. Activated CCTV, chilling.
Alright, here it comes, guys. Here it comes.
And play this one, then I'll play the next one. This one right before it. With the 1 minute intervals. It's gonna play 30 seconds. Then it's gonna stop for a minute.
Is it just me? Or I think this right here is something, right?
And within a minute, this weird shit happens.
At first, Austin's coworker is sleeping quietly and the CCTV camera doesn't detect any movement, other than some occasional tossing and turning in bed.
Nah, I still think that this is the real culprit right here, this face type thing.
But then, late into the night, the camera starts to record as something moves. Something that almost looks like the head of a person rising up underneath the sheets. When the woman awakes, the creepy figure vanishes into thin air. Austin's coworker claims that the video is 100% real, and even Austin himself says that he doesn't believe she would even know how to fake such a creepy encounter. But let me know what you think. Caught on camera.
So that was something I can tell you. I have no idea if it was real or not, but I think that it wasn't her leg, it wasn't her foot, it wasn't a stick, because if it were her legs or a stick, the clip would have been totally different. I mean, the blanket or whatever she was covering herself with fell down really smoothly after that thing that was sticking up disappeared. It went really smooth. It wouldn't have been so smooth if it were her legs or a stick. So comment down in the comment section if you know anything about this video.
Coleon is stopped by a Houston police officer for suspicion of driving under the influence. Officer still forces Joe to stand for 20 minutes to take. He noted here that Joe was later proven innocent in court.
Why are you making me do this? I will conduct your test, but I'm going to tell you this, that I'm handicapped.
Okay.
But you see, when I don't like this place, I have a false leg from my hip to my knee.
Okay.
Also, this police officer in the video later resigned after it was revealed that he had received multiple serious complaints of misconduct. For the full story, I highly recommend checking out the in-depth investigation over on the YouTube channel, San Joaquin Valley Transparency. When this video was posted, many YouTube viewers spotted something else in the video that was also very disturbing. Watch closely.
What the fuck? What the fuck? Oh, holy shit! Oh, no! How did this guy not see the motherfucking shadow walk across the... What the fuck, man? This can't be happening. How did not both of them... I mean, if not both of them, why didn't this guy saw the thing walking in a high fucking speed from here to there across the screen? And this motherfucker didn't even see when it reached there, maybe. He should have seen. Both of them should have seen this guy from this angle and this officer from that angle. Man, this motherfucking video is fake. But yeah, I can say that this motherfucking cop deserves to be in jail.
A strange figure that looks like a person seems to glide behind both Joe and the police officer at an oddly fast speed. Now, at first I thought this was simply a compression glitch caused by someone passing behind them in the dark, too far away from the camera to appear clearly. But that theory is pretty much disproven by the fact that multiple vehicles pass behind the two men, and all of them appear very well lit and highly detailed. So, what do you think this dark figure is? Is it something paranormal that was accidentally captured on police dashcam footage? You decide. You can watch a great video breakdown of this potential ghost footage over on the YouTube channel, San Joaquin Valley Transparency. And you can see the original full-length unfair arrest over on the YouTube.
Alright guys, so I think that this video was really annoying for me because the cop was not doing his job. How he's supposed to be, obviously he's a shitty cop, but I think that at least one of them should have seen that that silhouette or whatever that was, apparition going from here to there across the screen, and they should have seen that, but they didn't. So that makes me wonder if it was fake. So comment down in the comment section what you think, and let's continue.
Perfect for the top five, or if you have a ghost hunt shortcut and is on her way to an appointment. Did not.
Alright, so what's in this video? Bro. Fuck no, man. This. Nope. This is scary, man. This clip in itself is scary. I don't want to be in such a situation all alone with just a shitty camera. Nah, man, I'm okay. I'll just be shutting in my room. Fuck this.
Men där framme.
What the fuck?
Jävla skitskog. Men.
Shortly after posting the video, Elin receives a very disturbing message from one of her friends. The friend points out that a bizarre distorted face can be seen peeking out at Elin from behind a tree. What makes the footage even creepier is that
no. Fuck this, man. I'm gonna have nightmares for days. Nah. Oh shit, god damn, bro. Okay, man, let's continue.
There's another unexplained dark figure with glowing eyes. Now, the eyes at the bottom of the tree could simply be an animal. But just what is that?
Nah, bro.
After I reached out to Elin, she explained to me that she's a skeptic and doesn't really believe in the supernatural at all.
I want to make something very clear here. I don't believe in the paranormal. I am not scared of my own video. I think it's creepy looking, but I don't believe it to be a ghost. As for all these like ghost videos out there, I believe that there's always an explanation for them. It's just that we don't know what the explanation is.
She's never posted any paranormal videos to Instagram or to her YouTube channel. She says she's puzzled and just wants help in figuring out just what this strange shape could be.
Nah, wait a minute, let me tell you something. You should be grateful that that creature or paranormal stuff did not hurt you, or you would have been... You would not have been recording that clip saying that you don't believe in paranormal. You should be grateful, man. Fuck this shit.
Elin returns to the park a day later to look around in daylight. But she doesn't find anything that could explain what she captured on camera. She says that raccoons and possums are incredibly rare in Sweden and certainly don't usually show up in a city center park.
I think it was this tree. And for everyone claiming there's a den here, there's no f***ing den here. There's no den at all. Not by this tree either. As you can see, there are skyscrapers down there. So for everyone saying it's a lynx, like, no, we don't have lynx here. We don't have bears. We don't have raccoons. See all the wildlife here? All the bears and lynx. Oh my god. I can't believe there's so much wildlife here. It's like I'm in Yosemite.
So, what do you think? Could this be something paranormal? Could it be a creepy creature? And perhaps the most disturbing question of all, why does this strange thing seem to have long dark hair, like a person? Whispering in Church. Over on the channel Urbex Hill, YouTuber Christopher Hill is back with another urban exploration of a creepy old abandoned church in Cleveland, Ohio.
Oh my god, this guy. I don't know how many clips I've seen of this YouTuber in this same channel, Nuke's channel, Urbex Hill Man. We are homies at this point.
Ohio. This time, Chris is exploring an old Lutheran church that was built back in 5 feet, supporting the elegant architecture of the church interior. He finds furniture and belongings that date back to the 1980s, to the second in his tracks.
Okay, here it comes, guys, here it comes.
Did you hear it? The baffled explorer explains in his video that he hears something strange as he climbs the stairs to the second floor, but he's not sure just what the sound might be. So I decided to enhance the audio from this section. Now watch the clip again and listen closely.
Come on, man! Come on, Nuke! Can you help me? What the fuck? Nah. It wasn't even that clear. How can you say that it was? Can you help me? Nah, bro, it wasn't even that clear. Fuck this shit. It can be literally anything.
A mysterious childlike voice can be heard saying, "Can you help me?" And then seconds later, what sounds like the voice of an older woman seems to whisper, "It's a test." Chris has no idea what he just captured and continues on with his exploration on the second floor of the creepy church. Then much later, when he comes back to the same staircase again to head back down, it happens again. This time a voice can be heard whispering something. And again I enhance the audio, but this time I'm not able to make out just what is being said. It almost sounds like multiple voices whispering all at once. Listen again and let me know in the comments if you can make out anything that the creepy voices are saying.
Nah, bro, nobody is saying nothing. Nothing is saying nothing, nobody's saying nothing, so you don't have to suspect, paranoid about it. There was no sound, it was a normal clip, normal exploration. And one thing I'll tell you, that the only thing that urban explorer needs to do is, he needs to go to real haunted places, he needs to man up and be a man and go to some cemetery or Indian cemeteries. They don't have cemetery, we just have shrine guards. Those are real places to be in, and those are the places where you will find real ghosts. So go there, go make videos there, man. I much respect to all the YouTubers who make ghost contents, but you need to go there sometimes. But I don't think this clip is paranormal. I don't think so. So the only thing that this guy needs to do, he needs to get the hell out of this place, man. I don't want him to get injured by some homeless man.
Things take a very creepy turn.
Okay, something else happened.
Viewers,
okay?
Viewers of this channel point out to Chris that he might not have been alone in the old church.
Yeah,
while Chris did hear
guys.
The strange sounds and whispering, he didn't see this. A huge dark figure can be seen standing in a room at the end of the hallway. Chris turns to film close-ups of the church's stained glass windows, and when he pans back, the large mysterious figure is gone.
Holy shit. Wait a minute. Okay, it's not.
So did Chris capture voices and an apparition of spirits that haunt the old church?
A headless ghost!
You decide.
Or maybe a nun.
You can watch this full video and many more of Chris's explorations over on his YouTube channel, Urbex Hill. The Haunted Ranch. Mexican ghost hunter Crisel Luna and a friend traveled to an abandoned ranch.
Urbex Hill guys video, I don't know if it was genuine or not. But it was scary, okay? Yeah, you would not want to be alone in such abandoned churches, man. Not all churches, you believe it or not, not all churches, temples are homes for God. Sometimes people, us humans, have done really vile and heinous crimes in there. So it doesn't belong to God anymore. It becomes a devil's den because the human deeds are done in there, some vile things. Well, anyways, guys, so comment down in the comment section if you believe that clip was true or not. So we'll head further into the video.
In a small town in Jalisco, Mexico, Grisel talks to a local. Strange, unexplained sounds in the property's warehouse. They've heard footsteps going up the stairs to the second floor, and many even claim that they have seen the apparition of an elderly woman wandering the grounds. Grisel and her friend began their investigation on the second floor.
Son de las que como ahora los míos. Y dice salón que la verdad es bastante escabroso. Vean que tiene algunas
habitaciones. Get ready, guys.
Vamos a iniciar por esta. Vamos a ver qué es lo que hay aquí. Se ve que hay algunos muebles antiguos que ya están llenos de tierra.
Holy shit!
No! ¿Viste, Melissa? Se movió.
Come on, man! It can be a gust of wind.
I have to react that way. Yo vi como que se movió esto.
The two investigators make their way down into an old warehouse that is being used as a storage area. They find dust-covered furniture, discarded building materials, and even an old broken-down truck. And then things start to get a bit weird.
All right.
While exploring the dark and dusty warehouse, Grisel gets a very something.
Y acá se ve una bodega. A ver, vamos a entrar aquí. Ay, Dios, aquí se siente la temperatura mucho, mucho más fría. ¿Cómo la sientes tú, Melissa? Ay,
se escuchó.
Allá atrás. Ay, Dios mío, ¿qué será? Un gato, un perro. ¿Quién anda aquí? ¿Quién anda ahí? Está horrible, a ver, vamos a ver. Vamos a avanzar. ¡Ay! Estoy escuchando ruidos. ¿Quién anda ahí? ¿Sabes qué? Yo siento que alguien nos está siguiendo. Siente espalda, pero... ¿Quién eres?
¿Escuchaste?
¡Ay, como una mujer! ¡Ay! Escucha. Escuchan ruidos, como si alguien caminara ahí. ¡Ay, no! Sí. Vamos. Pero eso fue muy claro el... Como un lamento, como si alguien estuviera llorando. ¿Quién anda ahí? ¿Necesitas ayuda? ¿Quién eres? Una sombra. Allá atrás. ¡Ay, ay! ¡Ay! ¡Ay! ¡Vámonos! ¡Ay, no! Pero es que quiero ir a ver quién es.
The two investigators hear the sounds of something moving in the dark storage area. And then they hear disturbing moans that sound like a woman quietly weeping. Grisel and her friend start to regret their decision to come to the haunted farm at all, and they decide to end their investigation with a prayer. And that's when things take a terrifying turn.
Acabamos de hacer una oración por todas estas almas o por...
Come on, man, you are stupid! Stupid, 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 and stupid. First of all, that you think a mere human can help these souls to rest well? You think mere humans can do that, huh? You think you can help? You thought you could help these souls that are trapped in this place, man? Those souls are trapped in there because they do not belong to hell. They do not belong to heaven. That's why they are trapped. They are evil. Okay? Shut the fuck up and leave. and whispering prayers, I mean, and saying prayers in a place like this is just like throwing petrol in a fire, okay? They don't like prayers. If they are bad spirits, they don't like prayers, okay? So don't do that. You know, you're not putting them to rest. You're putting them in unrest, man. Okay? So leave.
Encuentra aquí porque hemos sido testigo y es muy muy impactante lo que hemos vivido dentro de este sitio donde sé que hay almas en pena o probablemente solo una que está aquí y que es la que se ha manifestado. Esta oración fue para ti y para todas las demás entidades que se encuentran aquí. Yo creo que es momento de retirarnos porque... ¡Ay, no mames, no mames, no mames! ¡Ah! ¡Ay, güey! ¡No mames, Ruby, algo! ¡Vamos, ven! ¡Ven, ven, ven! ¡Algo se asoma aquí! ¡Ven, por favor, algo! ¡Córrele, córrele, córrele!
Yeah, yeah, hurry up, hurry up and give the guy behind the truck time to disappear. Okay, I'm chill, I'm joking. Even if it wasn't a guy, if it was a ghost, man, you had it coming. I mean, you had it coming. You know that you disrespected everything in there.
No mames,
you invaded their space. Okay, yeah, right. It could have been a guy behind the truck because there is a whole ass gap for a guy to just show up his head from right here and just escape from the space, man. Fuck it, man.
Ay, ¿quién anda aquí? ¿Quién anda aquí? Yo ya no sé.
And these women, they don't sound scared. I mean, they sound aroused. They sound horny. They don't sound scary. I'm sorry, man, but this is it.
De verdad, no hay nada. Ay, no, vámonos ya. Vámonos, vámonos con cuidado, es momento de irnos.
A shadowy figure with dark hair and pale shoulders rises from behind the truck's cabin. Now to
right,
her credit,
right.
Chriselle
Wait,
fearlessly
see, see.
And pale shoulders rises from behind.
See, I'm just see and I'll tell you something, okay?
No,
watch, watch.
A shadowy figure with dark hair and pale shoulders rises.
Light. So that apparition was right here. It went from this to this in this angle. This angle because whatever was behind this truck escaped from down under to outside from that space. Okay, because if it was just an apparition, he could have been just down, maybe to this side, maybe to up, flying up there, or maybe down or this side. If it was a human, okay, it just went to this angle. See,
from behind the truck.
See for yourself, man. I'm not lying, it makes sense.
Vámonos, vámonos, con cuidado, es momento de irnos.
A shadowy figure with dark hair and pale shoulders rises from behind the truck's cabin.
That was it.
Now to her credit, Chriselle fearlessly rushes over to investigate, nearly tripping on the old boards covering the storage room floor. But there's no one there. The two friends have finally had enough, and they decide to just get out of there. So, are the stories about the ranch true? Does a dark female spirit roam the property? Or is it all just an elaborate hoax? You decide. You can find this full investigation over on the YouTube channel, Chriselle Luna. Thanks so much for watching.
Alright guys, so... okay guys, so that was it. That was Nuke's Top 5 Ghost Videos. So scary that he disappeared for a week, and I think only one clip made me scared, and that was that Lynx raccoon woman. That was something to spirits behind the trees, under the trees, something like that. That was scary. So comment down in the comment section what you think about these videos, what's up with you, and I'll see you guys in the next video. And big ups to Nuke. When he lets everyone react to his videos, and I'm a small, really underrated and small YouTuber, doing whatever I can to grow, but I like to react to his videos, even when I'm a gamer. So big ups to him. Subscribe to his channel and subscribe to my channel. Leave a like, comment down in the comment section, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Till then, goodbye, take care, I love you.